Are you having difficulties using nail foils? Do they transfer partially and with a crackle effect? Do you dream for a product to give you a full transfer with your nail foils every time? Hey y'all, welcome back. I am Paola of PaolaPonceNails.com. I am a certified nail technician and Japanese gel nail instructor, and I publish videos weekly primarily on soft gel nail education. If this interests you, at the end of this video, do consider subscribing. Today, I will be sharing with you 10 secrets so that you can master long-wearing transfer foils with a full coverage transfer every single time. And at the end of this video, I will have a foil nail giveaway you will not want to miss, so make sure to stick around. Secret number one, full coverage gel now exists. And in this video, I will be using my absolute favorite nail art brand, Daily Charms Nail Foil Transfer Gel, which is the new gel technology in transfer foil. It is unreal. So if you want to avoid crackle or patchy transfers, avoid using just gel base. Invest in a specific foil transfer gel. So how to use it? After completing your base gel nail service, you will take a thin amount of Daily Charm foil transfer gel and cure it. The bottle says 30 seconds before security and minimal tacky layer residue. I like to do 60 seconds. Secret number two. Now, are you ready for the biggest hack when using foil gel or foil transfer gel? Here it is. After the nail comes out of the lamp, I strongly recommend you wipe off the tacky residue with a lint-free wipe and either 90% alcohol or acetone. Why? Well, the tacky residue this particular gel leaves is actually a bit greasy and almost too slippery for the next gel layer to adhere to properly. Now, you may be thinking, well, is this not the part that allows the foil transfer to happen? And the answer is no. Transfer foil, whether you get it from Daily Charm or others, is weird. I actually came across this hack by mistake. I had done a beautiful transfer design on myself, but about a week later or so, my nail art, specifically my foil transfer art, began lifting like crazy. And I know lifting because I teach on it a lot, so I knew it was a very slim chance it was my gel-based application because this was a weird kind of lifting. So then I did my nails again and a similar thing happened, so I knew something was up. I trust Daily Charm products. They are of the highest quality, which is why I work with their products. And I also trust my gel nail method of application. So the picking at my nails became so satisfying that I started peeling my nails off at least a foil layer. And when I did that, there was a sticky layer behind that I could not wait to wipe off with alcohol. Well, I eventually did, only to realize a few minutes later that it had come back. So then I tried acetone and it was still there a few minutes later. So then I had the mentality of, if you can't beat them, then join them. And I just pressed fresh new foil on it, sealed it, and wham, they held on and I had a new design for the next 2 weeks or so. So the good news is that it saved me a little bit of time. So again, I recommend you wipe off that tacky residue foil gel leaves behind. In either case, whether you wipe or not, your foils will still transfer fully. Secret number three, apply non-acid primer, aka bonder, on the edge of your transfer foil application. This will keep your edges from lifting. Secret number four, turn your hands or client's hands over so that you can ensure a proper cure and avoid lifting at the free edge. Secret number five, gently buff or file the free edges inward before sealing the foil. Secret number six, not all foil is created equal. Avoid the no-name generic cheapies on Amazon or eBay. Not all are unreliable either, so definitely rely on reviews. Again, for me, as I am applying professional gel nail applications, I need a brand I can trust. I need that peace of mind. And so I'm sticking with what is working for me, and that would be Daily Charm. By the way, their foils are beautiful. Also, on the topic of not all nail foils being created equal, there are also thick nail foils out there from brands like European brand Emmy. I got suckered into buying these beautiful gradient ones, except that when I went to use it, it was so thick, not even transfer gel could pick it up. But I was determined to give it some use, and so cut it up, laid an uncured gel layer, then cured and peeled the foil off, and just like that, it went from my most hated foil to my absolute favorite. So to recap, if you are having issues with nail foils, it may not be you, it may very well be the foil, so keep your head up. Secret number seven, do not wrap foil transfer gel or foil around the nail's free edge. Again, this transfer foil gel is alive. Even after cured and being wiped, it remains tacky. Secret number 8, use a thin coat of base gel over your foil transfer before sealing it with a builder gel. This will ensure compatibility and that your builder gel adheres to your design properly. Secret number 9, wipe the back area of your foil with a damp alcohol lint-free wipe to remove any oils or other contaminants you may have left behind on the foil while handling. Make sure that alcohol solution evaporates before you press onto the nail. Secret number 10, rub or warm up your foils to make them more stretchy and flexible. This will help them transfer better also. And those are your 10 secrets to mastering nail foils. Now before I show you our giveaway items, you should know that while you can expect a video every Monday here, I do occasionally drop a bonus video Wednesday. And the only way to find out about these and also not miss a giveaway is to hit that notification bell icon. And if you would like to meet me live every Thursday, I host a free nail art lesson inside our private Facebook group. So if you want to join us, do join with the link in the description box below. Here are the items of our giveaway. To enter, use the link below. This giveaway ends next week. Thanks for watching. Until next time.